So we'll start with the first one, which was emotions and personal relevance. So you might have heard students in your class say, are we doing this again? Or why are we doing this? And you may have told students, well, this is part of our curriculum, or this is part of the state standards. Or you might have said, well, this is gonna be on the test, or you're gonna be evaluated on, especially when kids get a little bit older. And while those things may be true, that is not helping kids to become interested in learning. And what research has found is that the brain doesn't waste energy thinking about things that don't matter to us. We only think deeply about things that we care about. And if I think about students in classrooms, we want them to be deeply considering and thinking about their numbers, their letters, their writing, all those things that you do in the classroom. You want students to be really thinking about those things in deep ways. So in order to do that, we need to help students and connect that content that we teach in the classroom to their interests, to the things that they want to do, that they want to accomplish. So the implication for the classroom about this research finding is that students will pay attention and stay focused when the subjects or the topics discussed in class are personally relevant to them. So our job as educators is to build that bridge so students can really feel intrinsically motivated to connect with academic content, where they can see that if they learn what you are presenting to them, they are able to either meet their goals or do something that they are really passionate about. And one of the strategies that we can do, if you can go to the next slide, please, is to help the students relate the materials discussed in class to their life and personal interests. And we can do that through creating personal inventories. So I have seen this done in a variety of different ways, but personal inventories, or sometimes this is called all about me presentations, where you are really exploring with students, what are the things that they like to do? What are the things that they do well? Things that may be boring or difficult, and this can be specific activities in the class. It can be also related to different subjects. Some students are really passionate about math, others about science. So really getting to know your students, their subjects, if they play sports or hobbies, and even like exploring what are some of the special friendships that they may have either inside the classroom or with students from outside of school. And special adults in their lives, what are some of their family bonds? And it can be their immediate family, but it can also be meaningful adults that they have in their lives. So these personal inventories, what they help to do, they help you to do, is to get to know your students better. And you can display these inventories in the classroom so students can be recognized, and you can create a sense of community by really digging deeper into who are the students that are in your classroom. And for some of you, it may feel like something that you do at the beginning of the school year, August or September, and you may feel, well, this is a little late for this. But the thing is that students change as they are having experiences in the classroom with you or experiences at home in their communities, right? Kids really change during the school year. And sometimes you can be amazed, right? How different they are from when you receive them the first day of school to when they leave at the end of June. So really paying attention and getting to know your students in order to build that bridge, build that connection with the content, the academic content that you are teaching in the classroom. So when you are, for example, selecting readings or thinking about some of the research projects that you may do with your students, making sure they are related to those students' inventories, that they are really meaningful and relevant for your students. And then a good practice, and I love this one because it's a really getting to that metacognition, is to ask students to update those inventories during the school year and reflect on the changes. While maybe some students were excited about a particular subject, maybe some students didn't like math coming to your class, and then because you are passionate about math, maybe they have developed a love for math. So really building those connections and helping students reflect on who they are as learners and how what they are learning in class is related to their personal lives. So if you put this strategy into practice, one of the observable outcomes that you may notice is that students are able to pay more attention and focus for longer periods of time. And that's because they are more engaged, they're intrinsically motivated, and because you are building those connections between their personal interests with that academic material. So students are really able to make those deeper connections and learn in meaningful ways. So I know that Seesaw has some exciting lessons that really can be applied to enjoy this strategy in the classroom.
Yes, thank you, Dr. Martinez. So as we know, as teachers, one of our biggest hopes is for all of our students to be engaged and paying attention to the learning that's happening in the class. And so as Dr. Martinez shared, the power of using these personal inventories really helps in order to create the engaging learning experiences that relate to students' interests. And so as she mentioned, yes, Seesaw now offers an incredible subscription to standards aligned, ready to teach lessons that support students with skills that they need the most. And so one collection, as you see right here, My Awesome Year, invites students and teachers to learn about each other. As Dr. Martinez shared, again, personal inventories with open-ended questions, like the ones that we're going to see in this collection, support all of you as teachers in understanding your students so that you can create learning experiences that students care deeply about. So we're going to jump in and explore a My Awesome Year lesson. So as the teacher, I've already saved this lesson to my library, and I'm ready to assign it to my class. So I'm simply going to click the assign button and select my class or classes that will complete this lesson. Then, as a student, I would go to my activity tab over here and click on the add response button. Today, I'm going to complete this as the sample student to show all of you the student view. So here's an example of a My Hobbies personal inventory. In this collection, the first page of each lesson is an about the teacher page that the teacher fills out before they assign the activity to their students. This helps the students first learn more about their teacher, and second, to see an example of what they will be doing. And as you can see on my example, the teacher recorded their responses as well. So those younger learners, students who can't access the text, are able to listen to the response.
I like to read books and ride my bike.
Awesome. So the teacher completes it. And then the second page is going to be the student page. So on this page, students use all of the learning tools on the Seesaw Canvas to complete their personal inventory. They can take pictures, use video, draw as I'm doing here, or use the microphone to share about themselves. So I'm going to say that the thing I like to do in my spare time is play soccer. And then the hobby I like to do with someone else is to swim. Students can then head over here to the microphone, and I'm going to record so my teacher can hear me. In my spare time, I like to play soccer, and I love to go swimming with my family. Students then click the done button. And when they're completely done with this activity or any activity in Seesaw, they're going to simply click that green check to add it to their journal so that you as the teacher can learn all about their hobbies. Now, after students complete these pages, teachers can use this new information about their students, about all of your students, to create those meaningful, engaging experiences that are personally relevant. And of course, it's also really fun because the students can get to know their classmates better. We saw in the chat, Molly called out that, you know, personal inventory could be added to the blog, and that's an awesome way for students to be able to get to know each other within Seesaw. So we have, as Tracy mentioned, we have three My Awesome Year activities to share with you today that you can explore and assign to your class to get to know your students better. Now, even though these lessons have grade levels attached to them, you can, of course, use all three in any grade. And we're going to wait and we'll share the links at the end of the session in a participant handout, as well as in a follow-up email for all of you.
Yep, and it is, you're very true. Yep, it is. We're getting great feedback from you in the chat. Just a reminder, if you have questions, put them in the Q&A, but keep that chat coming in too. And we'll share these lessons a little later.